Hello everyone, it's Cherise and welcome back to another video. In today's video, we are setting up my bullet journal for July 2021. For the second half of the year, I will be working on my notebook therapy Tsuki Nara dotted journal, and I made a bullet journal migration or a mid-year bullet journal setup video earlier. So if you're interested to see how I did my spreads, you can check it out on the link I provided on the video description. I will be using watercolors for my July theme that I would like to call Tropical Dreams, with design elements where tropical meets bohemian. All the supplies I'm using in this setup, as well as my discount codes, are linked on the video description. I started to sketch everything out first with a pencil. For my cover page, I'm doing an illustration of a boho beachfront picnic setup with a hanging rattan swing chair, or I would say it's more like what you would see on a romantic, tropical bohemian-inspired wedding decors. I've done something bohemian as well from my March theme in the past, so I would like to bring that back again this month because I really like the colors and patterns of this style. After sketching the details, I then moved on to the painting process. I'm starting with the hanging rattan swing chair. The colors I'm using is yellow ochre for the lighter parts and dark brown for defining the details. A little fact I found about rattan is that it is a type of climbing or trailing vine-like palm native to the tropical regions of Asia, and one of the largest sources is the Philippines, which is my home country. So I began painting the outer part of the chair with the yellow ochre, then I added another layer on some areas to create a shadow. With the dark brown, I'm adding the details, that is the patterns you would see on a weaker rattan furniture. Then I also added the cushion and pillows in different colors. Now I'm painting this bent palm tree. I'm using the same yellow ochre for this long trunk. When using watercolors, I always wanted to start on a lighter shade first so I can control the intensity. So I wanted to match the direction of the shadows from the hanging chair that is on the right side, so I will be doing the same thing here. Before I proceed with the leaves, I painted the distant ocean first in the sky with a light blue color. You will see me starting with the horizon, then gradually go lighter as I go down by adding some more water. Then I keep adding another layer after it dried up to add depth to the horizon. I did almost the same thing with the sky, and because I painted directly on the page, I'm trying to be careful with the amount of water I'm using to avoid bleed through and to keep the paper from buckling. You can always use binder clips as I find them helpful to keep the pages flat. After that, I then continued with the palm leaves using the tip of the brush or a smaller brush for the narrow shapes. Now I'm painting the sand to give it more depth. I'm adding a couple layers of the same paint where the water overlaps the sand. Then above this, I'm using a very light shade of the same color and blended it to the ocean. Finally, I'm painting the remaining elements, that is the picnic setup, which I intentionally didn't include the dinnerwares, food, and picnic baskets. I just went with the boho rug with some throw pillows and poofs or cushioned low seats. Then I added the July title in the lighter part of the water using my Tombow Fudenosuke hard tip brush pen. So next, we have my quote page on the left side of the spread. I thought of making this wooden beach signs with variations in shapes and shades. The quote I chose for this month is, "Remember to enjoy the now." Then I'm adding a bouquet of tropical leaves on top and a couple on the bottom. I actually like how this spread turned out, and I hope you like it too. Now we can move on to set up our monthly calendar. I chose this square boho arch that is mostly used as a backdrop or an altar for beach wedding ceremonies. First thing I did is paint the decorations of the arch with flowers and tropical leaves accent on the left upper corner. Next is a flowing fabric that is wrapped around the top part of the arch through the right side with this ivory or cream color, which adds a soft touch that complements the theme. I'm using the same color for the shading by adding layers of thin lines to create folds of the fabric. Then I'm adding another set of flowers and tropical leaves on the right corner. And the last piece of decor for this illustration is the vintage lantern just beside the left post of the arch. Now the illustration is finally done. I went ahead with the calendar on the space in the middle by drawing 7 horizontal lines. Each line are 4 dot spaces apart, and for this I combined the weekends. To complete this whole spread is the July at a glance title, again using my Tombow Fudenosuke hard tip brush pen. This spread really looked elegant for me, though it seems very light here in the video because of the lighting. Anyway, I will be sharing the photos on my bullet journaling Instagram, so if you'd like to see my spreads, you can definitely follow me there as well. So that is it for our monthly calendar, and now let's get to the next one. I'm dedicating the left page for a very simple and minimal content planner for my Instagram and YouTube channel using this layout that I always use many times now. I divided the page into 2 vertical sections and created borders for each using the fine tip of my Tombow ABT in number 942. Then I wrote the days and dates of the month in the middle. I know this spread may not be useful for some of you, but you can definitely try it for something else like cleaning checklist or maybe a master to-do list page. On the right side is my priorities, which I just renamed for my monthly goals. With a few brush strokes, then below is my socials tracker where I track my monthly following and subscriber count. If you are already a follower and subscriber, thank you so much. You are the best. To add some decoration to this page, I decided to create this tropical leaves pattern. So there are banana leaves, monstera, fern, and a variety of palm leaves. I also tried to make the colors a combination of green and yellow and brownish tones for the dried ones. After painting, I turned this page into a Dutch door using my X-Acto knife. This time, I tried something different than my usual straight Dutch doors by cutting the outline of the painting so the edges are curvy. Then I glued the painting on the page next to it. So the other side of the Dutch door page will be for my package tracker where I will write the item description and check off the S that stands for shipped and R for received. Then on the bottom will be for my shopping list. I didn't put categories this time because this will just serve as an additional for me as we doubled the groceries this June and we're trying to minimize expenses for July. So by looking at this, it will immediately remind me to evaluate things that is really needed to purchase. I wanted to use this space on the right for my habit tracker. I have 8 habits to track, so I drew these rectangular shapes with 3x12 dot spaces. Only that I cut the first line into 7, so it will fit 31 days and write the habits from there. To be honest, I never thought I could fit these with the space, so I find it really cool. Now we're finished with this Dutch door. With lots of trackers I was able to fit in, it's time to set up our first weekly spread. And since I did a Dutch door layout on the previous page, it made me want to make my weeklies into Dutch doors as well, but this time it's going to be horizontal. So I started cutting 4 pages where the top is smaller than the bottom. Not only that, but these Dutch doors will also come in tabs. I saw some using this layout in their bullet journals, so I thought it would be awesome to try it out. After that, I glued all the top part of the pages so it would look like this. The final painting I'll be doing in this video is another Bohemian picnic style. Of course, there has to be a teepee or a portable conical tent made of skins, cloth, or canvas on a frame of poles. So I'm painting that here on the left area along with tropical bouquet as well that is attached on it. I also painted another one to the right with a round rug and added the same set of decorations here and there. There will also be 3 posts around with hanging lights. And lastly, to put this painting together is this hanging double swing chair that I think made this whole theme something that I wish I can turn into reality because I would love to hang out here and have a great time. Now I'm painting the first tab for my first weekly spread with this yellow-green color as well as the round backgrounds for the days. Then I drew vertical boxes for each and I divided it into 2 for events and tasks. I just wrote the days in a very simple cursive font and we are all done. If you're interested to see the rest of the spreads that I'll create, make sure to follow my Instagram account for more inspirations. And here is the final flip through of my July 2021 bullet journal setup. They look refreshing, that is perfect, especially I'm using a new journal starting this July. If you love this tropical and bohemian theme, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to like this video and to tag me for recreations. Stay tuned for the next bullet journal video by subscribing to the channel, and I will talk to you again very soon. Bye!